Hello and namaskar. My name is Rajiv Banerjee and I'm part of the corporate communications team at HDFC Bank. Welcome to In Conversations. Today we are at Anjanapur village, which is in the district of Ahmednagar in Maharashtra, very close to the holy town of Shirdi. At Anjanapur, under Parivartan, which is the CSR brand of the bank, we have worked what we call as Holistic Rural Development Program. In fact, Anjanapur is one of the 1,000 villages where the bank has worked under HRDP. We will, in a short while, have with us Ms. Ashima Bhatt, who's the Group Head CSR for HDFC Bank.
Hi, Rajiv. Good morning.
How are you doing?
Good, all well.
All well. Ashima, thank you so much for your time and welcome to In Conversation in Anjanapur. How does it feel to be out here in the countryside?
It's actually always a pleasure to come to the countryside. It's pure, fresh air, clean drinking water and great food. And actually, these are the locations which make up real India. And which is why when we work in Parivartan at HDFC Bank, these are the locations where we can actually see the transformation happening.
So Ashima, tell us about the philosophy behind Parivartan.
See, the very name Parivartan is talking about change, but it also means sustainable change, because that is what really makes the difference. We can come change something in these locations, but unless it's sustainable, which is also the philosophy that we follow, that we don't just make the change, we co-create the change. So we involve the local bodies, the teachers, the villagers, so that there is a sense of ownership in what we are doing.
Right.
When we walk into a place like this and we are changing, say, for example, the school, the water, the agriculture or the solar lighting, we do it in such a way that there is a sense of belonging of each of the interventions. So through Parivartan, that is what is very, very different on what the bank does. And that is the tone at the top, right down to the CSR team. See, typically in a school like this, we would do a lot of smaller projects. We would do the sanitation unit that you can see behind you. We would do the wall painting to make learning more fun for the children. We also work in developing the classroom through a digital classroom that we would have done. Hasi nahi aa rahi, nahi aa rahi. Badi si smile.
So Ashima, Lagdi looks interesting.
Absolutely, this looks like a lot of fun. Mere ko kaun out karega?
After how many years did you like actually do Langdi?
I think I've lost count, but it was great fun. I think playing with children makes you feel younger and younger.
Truly,
so
does.
I really enjoyed it.
Yeah. So talking about children and coming to education, you know, education is one of the main pivots in Parivartan. And here we are not just talking about education for children, but even the training that we do for teachers. Tell us a little more about that.
A very important part of Parivartan is the education of the children and how we can make it more interesting, more invigorating for the children. But also more importantly, one of the largest programs we run is what we call Teach the Teachers. And in this program, we have trained almost about 16 lakh teachers across the country. Because only if a teacher is well trained and she understands the subject is when she can make the subject more interesting and invigorating for the children.
The innovation bit is a win-win for both, don't you think so? Because, you know, innovation is actually helping the teachers as well as the school children, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And what we firmly believe is that innovation doesn't necessarily have to come at a cost. So through our Teach the Teachers program, we realize that the teachers are full of ideas and very simple ideas on how they can make education more fun. And we always remember a teacher from the past who made us learn without us even realizing that we were learning.
Yeah.
So that's very important.
Absolutely. Here, the bank has facilitated a financial literacy workshop for women. Literacy and the financial literacy and the importance of that is really high because, you know, that's a very, very critical component of what we do in Parivartan.
Yeah. So we firmly believe that giving financial literacy to women is actually empowers the full family.
Right.
So in these workshops, which we conduct thousands of throughout the country, we teach them about basic saving in terms of how to prioritize consumption so that they can create much more wealth for themselves and their families.
Right.
And that is what brings about real improvement. And we do this through our instructors.
Yeah.
नमस्कार 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 तो ये जो वर्कशॉप हम करते हैं आपके लिए इससे आपको क्या फायदा मिल रहा है?
वो हेल्थ के बारे में बताती है, कैसे रहने चाहिए, खुद की सफाई जरूरी है, खुद का ख्याल रखना जरूरी है।
हाँ, वो तो बहुत जरूरी है।
हाँ, सबसे जरूरी।
अगर अगर महिला घर की महिला
स्वस्थ रहेगी तो सब परिवार स्वस्थ रहेगा।
हाँ, बिल्कुल ठीक बोला आपने। और क्या सिखाते हैं आप इनको यहाँ पे?
ऑनलाइन ट्रांजेक्शन है, नेट बैंकिंग कैसे करना है, हमारी जो रिचार्ज कैसे करना है।
रिचार्ज ही करते हैं या बैंक का भी काम करते हैं उस पे?
ऑनलाइन हॉस्पिटल का बिल वगैरह।
आप मोबाइल से करते हैं?
मोबाइल से।
अरे क्या बात है, बहुत अच्छा। So Ashima, we just saw the financial literacy workshop happening. In your opinion, how important it is to empower women, particularly in rural India, to make a sustainable change?
See, it's very, very important. And also the access to the information that they have, while we in the cities feel that it's available, in rural India, they have very limited access. So it's very important to teach them about financial literacy, to give them that empowerment. Because once, like I mentioned, once a woman changes, then it benefits the entire family.
Ashima, tell us, when you visit villages, and you would have visited quite a few of them. When you see the work done by the bank under Parivartan, what gives you the greatest satisfaction?
I think the best satisfaction comes from seeing that there is holistic change. So what we call the HRDP, Holistic Rural Development Program, under that we just don't do one intervention. We are doing multiple interventions in the village. I think one of our important interventions is the biogas that we are doing, which then impacts each of the households. So that is what brings real change, and that's what gives us the immense satisfaction that we are making a difference.
Yeah, so indeed, when you talk about biogas, and then we are at one of the households where the beneficiary has benefited out of the biogas that we have installed. So we have Rohini with us. And in fact, let me also tell you an anecdote, Ashima. In Anjanapur village, about more than 100 households homes have biogas installed.
Correct.
And I was talking to them and they're saying that, cumulatively or collectively, they have saved close to 4 lakh rupees. And that's fantastic, not just from a money-saving point of view, but also the fact that it's environmentally friendly, it's a natural fuel, it's good for health, for the women who are cooking. So overall, it's a very fantastic change and sustainable change that we have brought about. So Ashima, we have come to the end of show. Your parting thoughts?
I think my final thoughts would be what you see currently around you. Look at the greenery in this place. I think one of the large interventions the bank has done is the tree plantation drive. So Anjanapur is one of the villages which comes under the rain shadow area. And the villagers were very concerned that the green cover in the village should increase because that attracts the rain. So we worked with them on that. In fact, one very interesting fact about Anjanapur is that every time a girl child is born in the village, they plant a tree. Their duty to kind of nurture it and make it grow. Yeah. So which is why you see the lovely lush greenery around here. So what you would notice is that when the bank works in this holistic program, it's a multifaceted program. And you've seen today the education that we would do, the school, the biogas, the solar lighting, and the tree plantation. So that makes it a complete inclusive growth, and that's what brings power to the village as well.
Absolutely, and I think so. It's a fantastic change that the bank is doing on the ground. Thank you so much, Ashima, for your time. Really a pleasure having you here on our show In Conversation.
It's a pleasure is all mine. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks so much, Rajiv.
That's it from us, from the village of Anjanapur. Thank you.